Superalignment refers to the challenge of making sure that future AI systems, meaning systems with super intelligent capabilities, act in accordance with human values and intentions. Now, today, alignment, just the regular non-super kind, that helps ensure that AI chatbots and the like aren't perpetuating human bias or being exploited by bad actors. But as AI becomes more advanced, its outputs become more difficult to anticipate and align with human intent. Now, that actually has a name. That is called the alignment problem. And the more intelligent that these AI systems become, this problem could become bigger. So let's consider we have intelligence and it's going up over time. Now, today we're at the level called ANI. That stands for artificial narrow intelligence. And that includes LLMs, autonomous vehicles, recommendation engines, basically the AI that we have today. Then the next level up from that is AGI. That's artificial general intelligence. It's theoretical, but if it's ever realized, we'll be able to complete all cognitive tasks as well as any human expert using AGI. And then at the top of the tree is ASI, artificial superintelligence. And ASI systems would have an intellectual scope that goes beyond human level intelligence. And if we have ASI, then we'd better make sure we have a pretty good super alignment strategy in place to manage it. So let me give you three reasons why we need super alignment, and then we'll get into some of the techniques. Okay, so reason number one is loss of control. Super intelligent AI systems may become so advanced that their decision-making processes outstrip our ability to understand them. When an ASI pursues its objectives with superhuman efficiency, even the smallest, teeniest, tiniest misalignment could lead to catastrophic unintended outcomes. Now, there's also strategic deception. So even if an ASI system appears to be aligned, we need to ask ourselves a question. Is it really? Because the system could strategically fake alignment, masking its true objectives until it's acquired enough power or enough resources for its own goals. And even some of today's AI models, the ANI models, they have engaged in primitive levels of alignment faking. So, well, we'd better watch out. Then there's self-preservation. So ASI systems might develop power-seeking behaviors for preserving their own existence that go far beyond their primary human-given objectives. Now, none of this is desirable. In fact, it probably represents an existential risk to humanity. So what can we do about it? Well, fundamentally, superalignment has two goals. The first of those is to have scalable oversight. So that means methods that allow humans, or even trusted AI systems actually, to supervise and then to provide high quality guidance when the AI's complexity makes direct human evaluation just basically infeasible. And the second goal is to make sure that you have a robust governance framework. Now, that framework ensures that even if an AI system becomes super intelligent, it remains constrained to pursue objectives that are aligned with human values. But that's all well and good, lofty goals, but how do we achieve that? Well, the techniques we use for alignment today often rely on a technology called RLHF. That's an acronym for Reinforcement Learning from Human Feedback, in which human evaluators provide feedback on the outputs of an AI model. And then that feedback's used to train a reward model that quantifies how well the model's responses align with the human preferences. But for super intelligent systems, human feedback systems alone are just basically unlikely to be scalable enough. We can't rely on this for ASI. So one super alignment technique instead is called RLAIF. That stands for reinforcement learning from AI feedback. So in RLAIF, AI models generate the feedback to train the reward functions, and that in turn helps align even more capable systems. It turns out this is quite a promising area of study, but we do have to consider that if the ASI system engages in alignment faking, then relying solely on AI-generated feedback might lead to further misalignment. There are some other techniques as well. For example, weak to strong generalization. That's another approach where a relatively weak model, perhaps one trained with human supervision, is then used to generate pseudo-labels or training signals for a stronger model. Now, the stronger model learns to generalize the patterns from this trained weaker model, and then it can generate correct, secure solutions in situations that the weaker model did not anticipate. So effectively, the stronger model learns to generalize beyond the limitations of its teacher. Now, one other technique is called scalable insight. This is where a complex task is broken down into simpler subtasks that humans or lower capability AI systems can more reliably evaluate. Now that's called iterated amplification, where a complex problem is broken down recursively. Now, given that we don't have ASI systems yet, superalignment is a largely uncharted research frontier. Future research, though, is looking into things like distributional shift. This is where alignment techniques are measured on how they perform when an AI encounters tasks that wasn't covered during the training. And there's also oversight scalability methods to amplify human or AI-generated feedback so that even in extremely complex tasks, the supervisory signal remains robust. It continues to listen to us. So superalignment, it's really all about enhancing oversight. It's about ensuring robust feedback, and it's about anticipating emergent behaviors. All of this for a technology that does not yet and might not ever actually exist. But if artificial superintelligence really does emerge someday, we'll want to be very sure that systems that are smarter than any of us will still be aligned to our own human values.